Good evening. We're just about to start the class. There is just 3 minutes, 2 minutes to eight. So Freud is already connected. And we just move on to this camera. Just to have that. Okay. That it's just 1 minute to eight. And just Morena, Flor Morena is already on the class, but she's away. So I just waiting for her to start the class. Okay, right now there is 8 p.m. already. Just waiting for the people to get in to the class. Good evening, Morena. Flor, how are you today?
Hola, buenas noches.
Good evening. How are you? Good.
Bien, gracias a
ti. Okay. Thanks God.
Me había dejado hablando solo, ¿verdad?
Cabal. Okay. We are going to start the class. Today is Wednesday, the 25th. Tuesday, the 25th. Okay, solo faltan un par de días. El viernes terminamos el módulo 3, para empezar ya en septiembre el módulo 4. Okay,
este viernes se termina.
Sí, este viernes. El viernes es la última clase.
Septiembre 4, me dijeron.
¿Perdón?
Me dijeron que terminábamos septiembre 4. La persona que me llamó la semana pasada. Me dijo que septiembre 4.
Al menos ahorita, hasta donde yo tengo entendido, terminamos el viernes 28. Ah, bueno. Probablemente es septiembre 4, empezamos. Es la última fecha para presentar la documentación, me parece. No estoy ahorita, sí tengo el correo de, ¿cómo se llama? ¿Cuándo empezaríamos? Pero déjeme solo verificar una parte acá. Bueno, no, al menos no tengo fecha todavía cuando empezaríamos el módulo 4. Entonces, solo déjeme ver. No tengo fecha todavía. El correo que me mandaron es nada más informativo. Igual que se les ha mandado a ustedes los requisitos para participar. Nada más. Uh-huh. No tengo ahorita fecha, pero sí sé que a principios de septiembre estaríamos empezando el módulo 4. Ok. Vamos ahorita a la videoconferencia number 17, How to use Bitcoin 2. Ok, si recuerda, Flora, we already covered past. We already covered present, right? The present tenses. We already covered the past. And today we are going to cover the future. Ok, el viernes vamos a hacer un pequeño repaso de todas las estructuras que hemos estado viendo para que tengan ahí esa información junta. Okay, so today's class objective is at the end of the class, students will be able to make a hotel reservation and request related services by using Bitcoin 2. Si se acuerda, ayer hicimos una pequeña conversación, un pequeño roleplay de cómo reservar un hotel, una habitación de hotel. Ahora vamos a ver prácticamente lo mismo, pero le vamos a agregar la estructura Bitcoin 2. Okay, so that is for future. Okay, so the agenda for today is warm up, review topics and vocabulary covering the last session, discuss and conversation practice. We go over to our role play and how to use Bitcoin 2, which is the structure. Role play, we're going to make another role play, and we're going to make a review about today's class. Okay, so as of now, as always, we're going to make a review what we learned yesterday. ¿Qué se acuerda del día de ayer? ¿Qué es lo que vimos?
Permítame.
Okay.
Estuvimos viendo lo de, vimos las reservaciones, algún vocabulario de que se utiliza para reservaciones y lo que uno necesita cuando se hospeda en algún hotel.
Okay, very good. Muy bien. Estuvimos viendo vocabulario de reservaciones. Okay. También, por ejemplo, ¿cuál es el vocabulario que se acuerda? Empezamos a single room, remember, and a double room. The amenities, so in that case, the services the hotel gives. For example, shuttle service. We have Wi-Fi internet. We have laundry. Okay. We have service room. Also, we cover business center. Okay, ¿qué otro vocabulario se acuerda?
Tengo anotado. Tengo anotado casi las mismas. Single room, double room. Laundry service, Wi-Fi internet, fridge in the room.
Okay, very good. Fridge in the room, very good. So it's something that I basically, thank you, Carlos, for joining us, for joining to the class. Okay, It's something that you have a fridge, que tiene un pequeño refrigerador, un pequeño refri con bebidas, right? Ahí usted puede agarrar las bebidas que usted guste, pero acuérdese que eso va cobrado. Que ahí ven, hacen el inventario, qué es lo que tienen, qué es lo que tomó, y de acuerdo a lo que tomó, es lo que se le cobra. Okay, very good. Carlos, we are making a review about what we covered yesterday, the vocabulary, and basically how to book a hotel. Okay, ¿qué vocabulario se acuerda, Carlos, de lo que vimos ayer?
Lo del hotel, shuttle service, laundry service, Wi-Fi, internet.
Very good.
No smoking room, a smoking room.
Solo eso. Okay, very good. Okay, and if you go to page number 40, we have some vocabulary there, right? So the shuttle service, remember that is the service that the hotel provide, transportation, right? From the hotel to any place. So probably will be at tourist places, or it will be from on the airport to the hotel and vice versa, right? So from the hotel to the airport in case you need to go to the airport. Very good. Business center. What is a business center? ¿Qué es un business center? ¿Qué decíamos ayer? ¿Qué es un business center?
Un centro de negocios.
Okay.
Los hoteles. Que se pueden ocupar. Se pueden utilizar, pueden ser hasta salones. Algunas veces hay unas salas de reunión.
Very good. There are some, yes, there are some rooms that you can use as meetings, right? So that is the business center.
Okay. Teacher, pero esos yes. centros de negocio, ¿cómo los, no sé, cómo los puedo ejemplificar? Digamos, como un ejemplo, porque según entiendo es solo salones de reuniones, o es que en un lugar puedo, puedo, ¿cómo se llama?, congregar varias áreas de negocio, algo así.
Ok, básicamente son como unas salas. Ya les voy a mostrar algo parecido. Les voy a mostrar acá, ya les comparto. Ahorita le comparto la pantalla. Solo por ejemplificar, solo déjeme ver acá. No sé si pueden ver ahí la picture. Básicamente es eso. Es como son tipo rooms as a business center. Thank you, Julia. Thank you, Carla, for joining us to the class. If you have, there are different type of business centers. It depends of the hotel, right? So that is a little small rooms where you can have a meeting. Okay, if you see in this picture, let me just to verify if, okay, sorry for that. But if you see in this picture, that is a small room where you can have a meeting. Okay, remember hotels are big and there are small and big rooms in order to have a meeting. Okay, they have projectors, they have, the room is basically, the environment is adequate just to have those kind of meetings. Okay, ahí depende del hotel, ¿verdad? ¿verdad? ¿Qué tanto espacio va a ocupar para ese tipo de servicio? No sé si está claro, Carlos. Yes. Okay. Very good. Okay. So, what else do you remember about yesterday class? ¿Qué más se acuerdan de la clase de ayer? Julia, what do you remember about yesterday class?
And to make a reservation.
Okay, to make a reservation. Very good. Okay, very good. So basically, that is the vocabulary that we cover. Laundry service, save, if you need to save something important like jewelry or money, or some important documents that you want to keep in safe. Okay, so what we're going to do right now, I'm going to play an audio. This is regarding the hotel reservation. Thank you, Tatiana, for joining us. Good evening.
Good evening.
We're going to listen. And let me, sorry for that. Okay, let me know if you listen the audio, and otherwise I need to share in another way. ¿Lo escuchan? Yes? Okay, very good. Let's listen to this and then we're going to discuss what we are what this conversation is about.
Majestic Hotel, can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to find out about your room rates in July, please.
One moment, please. I'll put you through to reservations. Reservations, can I help you?
Yes, I'm inquiring about room rates in July, please.
Yes, of course, sir. Do you have specific dates in mind?
Yes, we're thinking of coming up the weekend of the 6th of July and staying for about a week, going back on Saturday the 13th or Sunday the 14th.
I see, sir. And for how many people would that be?
Well, there's myself, my wife and our two children. They're 9 and 5.
Well, there are various options. We could do a double for you and your wife and a room with two singles for your children. Not adjacent, though.
Is it not possible to have a family room for all of us?
Yes, that is a possibility. Just let me check those dates for you. It is a very busy time of year, as I'm sure you realise.
Yes, I appreciate that.
Well, I can offer you a family room for the nights of Saturday the 6th through to the night of Thursday the 11th, but I'm afraid there are no family rooms for the second weekend. They're all booked already, I'm afraid.
Oh dear. So that would mean either leaving on Friday or moving to two rooms for the last one or two nights, would it?
Yes, I'm afraid so. But I see we do have a suite available for all the nights you are interested in. That would give you two separate bedrooms, a sitting room, bathroom of course, and the one we have available also has a large balcony and a terrific sea view.
Oh, well, that sounds wonderful. But what about the price? Can you do any special deals on that?
Okay, what is this conversation about? Can you tell me, or can you tell to the class? Yes. Did you take any note or any, do you have any idea what it is about?
Reservation in a hotel for a vacation.
Okay, very good.
With the family.
With his family. Very good. What else can you tell us? ¿Qué más podemos decir for about this conversation? Okay, I will play once again. Okay, let's listen and I will play this. Okay, let me. Play this.
Majestic Hotel, can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to find out about your room rates in July, please.
One moment, please. I'll put you through to reservations. Reservations, can I help you?
Yes, I'm inquiring about room rates in July, please.
Yes, of course, sir. Do you have specific dates in mind?
Yes, we're thinking of coming up the weekend of the 6th of July and staying for about a week, going back on Saturday the 13th or Sunday the 14th.
I see, sir. And for how many people would that be?
Well, there's myself, my wife and our two children. They're 9 and 5.
Well, there are various options. We could do a double for you and your wife and a room with two singles for your children. Not adjacent, though.
Is it not possible to have a family room for all of us?
Yes, that is a possibility. Just let me check those dates for you. It is a very busy time of year, as I'm sure you realise.
Yes, I appreciate that.
Ah, well, I can offer you a family room for the nights of Saturday the 6th through to the night of Thursday the 11th, but I'm afraid there are no family rooms for the second weekend. They're all booked already, I'm afraid.
Oh dear, so that would mean either leaving on Friday or moving to two rooms for the last one or two nights, would it?
Yes, I'm afraid so. But I see we do have a suite available for all the nights you are interested in. That would give you two separate bedrooms, a sitting room, bathroom of course, and the one we have available also has a large balcony and a terrific sea view.
Oh, well, that sounds wonderful. But what about the price? Can you do any special deals on that?
Okay, what else did you get for this conversation? Carla? ¿Qué más pudieron, qué más información obtuvieron de la conversación? Yes, Carla?
He needs to stay 1 week. Okay. At the beginning the year offers one double room and one single room for the kid, but he demands a family room.
Family room, very good.
But there are a problem with the second weekend because it's empty.
Okay, very good.
So the girl offers an option with a suite. I think it's a suite with a terrific view of the city.
Okay, yes, very good. Okay, now I will share once again, I will play the audio and now I will share the script. So you will see, you will read while you listen to the audio. Let me just share this part. Okay, let me know when you can see the screen. Do you see it?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, very good. Let me just play the audio and you will follow the reading.
Majestic Hotel, can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to find out about your room rates in July, please.
One moment, please. I'll put you through to reservations. Reservations, can I help you?
Yes, I'm inquiring about room rates in July, please.
Yes, of course, sir. Do you have specific dates in mind?
Yes, we're thinking of coming up the weekend of the 6th of July and staying for about a week, going back on Saturday the 13th or Sunday the 14th.
I see, sir. And for how many people would that be?
Well, there's myself, my wife and our two children. They're 9 and 5.
Well, there are various options. We could do a double for you and your wife and a room with two singles for your children. Not adjacent, though.
Is it not possible to have a family room for all of us?
Yes, that is a possibility. Just let me check those dates for you. It is a very busy time of year, as I'm sure you realise.
Yes, I appreciate that.
Well, I can offer you a family room for the nights of Saturday the 6th through to the night of Thursday the 11th, but I'm afraid there are no family rooms for the second weekend. They're all booked already, I'm afraid.
Oh dear. So that would mean either leaving on Friday or moving to two rooms for the last one or two nights, would it?
Yes, I'm afraid so. But I see we do have a suite available for all the nights you are interested in. That would give you two separate bedrooms, a sitting room, bathroom of course, and the one we have available also has a large balcony and a terrific sea view.
Oh, well, that sounds wonderful. But what about the price? Can you do any special deals on that?
Okay, very good. So, do you have any questions of our vocabulary? No questions? Everything's fine?
No, and Kyren? Mm-hmm. In Kyren? Yes, I am Kyren about room.
Okay, inquiring is asking for a request. Yes, I'm inquiring about room rates in July. So in this case, I'm requesting about room rates in July.
And the infinitive is? What is the infinitive inquiring?
Inquiring?
Is a regular verb?
Uh-huh. Inquire, yes, is a regular verb. Mm. But in this case, remember, it's another structure. In this case, it's present progressive. That's why we add ing form. But and it's a regular verb, inquired. Okay, any other question? Carlos, Julia, Tatiana, Flor. Thank you for joining us, Joel. Thank you for joining us, Erica. I don't know if you have any other question besides that. On the second page, any vocabulary? Nope. Okay. Very good. Basically, this is what people used to ask when they're trying to book a hotel room. So if you see, we go over to this one. I like to find out about your room rates. Another way to say it is room prices. Los costos de los cuartos de hotel, right? So that's the rates. Okay, very good. Okay, basically that's what I needed just to share in order just to continue with the summary or the recall previous learning about yesterday class. Very good, guys. So let's move on to the next part of the presentation. And let's do this. And I will share this screen. That we have this part. Okay, so we already done that. So we went over to the vocabulary as well. We just review or just listen another conversation about booking a hotel. Okay, right now we're going to go to the discussion and conversation practice. We're going to discuss the first activity. the questions in the first activity. So on page 41. So if we move to the textbook on page 41, we have some questions there. Okay, if you see, I need that you discuss these questions. Do you prefer to stay in a modern or antique hotel when you travel? Do you usually make your hotel reservations or someone else does it for you? So I will give you just 5 minutes. We're going to work in pairs doing this, just the first activity. Okay, very good. Let me just do the pairs.
Teacher.
Yes. Hoy sí le escuchamos.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Welcome.
I have a question.
Dígame.
What is rates?
Rates son los costos. O en este contexto podemos entenderlos como los precios.
Ajá, correcto. Okay, thank you, teacher.
Welcome. Okay, we're going to work in pairs and discuss the questions on page 41. Okay, let's do this one. And we're going to have Carlos and Joel. We're going to work Erica and Carla. And we have Flor, Julia, and Tatiana. So let's work on that.
Teacher.
Yes.
Yo no tengo ese material de apoyo. Creo que me regala ahí la imagen para capturarlo.
Ok, no hay problema. Ahorita la comparto.
Lo que está en la página 41, ¿verdad, teacher?
Sí, es las preguntas.
La parte 1.
Sí.
Okay. Do you prefer to stay in modern or antique hotels?
Me avisa para tomarle captura de pantalla y moverme de grupo.
Vaya, teacher, ya estuvo.
Ok, thank you.
Hello. Sí, es que teacher, no escuché la indicación por buscar la página 41.
Ok, don't worry, that's fine. Ok, so we're going to discuss the question. Solo vamos a discutir las preguntas de la actividad número 1. Son 2 preguntas nada más. Do you prefer to stay in a modern or antique hotels when you travel? Y la otra, do you make your hotel reservations or someone else does it for you? Solo esas 2 preguntas vamos a discutir y después las vamos a discutir en el grupo.
Ok, gracias.
Welcome.
Bye. Ya, aunque sea pequeño.
Con las comodidades.
Ajá. Mire, yo acabar eso más que todo, porque a veces son chiquitos y la gente es bien amable y todo eso, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh. Exacto. Entonces eso, depende del lugar.
Ajá.
Si es un lugar así como, ¿cómo? Antiguo, no antiguo, sino... No sé, donde hay ruinas y cosas así.
Ajá. Sí. No, ajá, pero hay unos que son como bien ordenaditos, aunque sean rústicos, ¿verdad?
Sí. Y me gusta, digamos, ir a lugares donde hay antigüedades.
Ajá. Y que es bien bonito.
Cabal, así que de eso. Mi respuesta es esa. Depende del lugar.
Depende del lugar donde visiten.
Uh-huh.
That's good. Okay, let's move on to the second question and I will give you 2 more minutes. Okay.
Ya sí. Ya me sacó. ¿Y la segunda cuál es?
De cobre le siguen cobrando.
A la
Sí, no, está frito.
Puta. No, pero te digo, así a las cabales, este...
Sí, de chingue, ¿cómo es?
Sí, ya me aburrí.
You finished, guys?
No, teacher, a empezar, vamos.
Okay, very good. I will give you 2 more minutes because
okay, the time. Okay, thank you, teacher.
Welcome.
¿Prefieres quedarte un...?
Do you usually make your hotel reservation? Sería como uh-huh. sueles hacer una reserva, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh.
Or some else does it for you. Uh-huh. O alguien más la hace por ti, ¿verdad?
Very good.
No.
Yo la hago.
No. Son
bueno, no, aunque una vez sí me la hicieron porque me hicieron un paquete, me hicieron todo.
No, son grandes. No sé qué se dice. Hacer, ya se me olvidó.
¿Tú?
No, that's it, pero no, someone does it or someone do it.
Someone does, porque estamos hablando de alguien más.
Ajá, someone does. Mm-hmm. That's it for me.
That's it. El it se refiere a la reservation.
Ajá, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Antique Hotel.
Y la segunda es que si usualmente uno hace la reservación o la hace alguien más por nosotros. Pero es que ahí depende, porque la va a reservar, ¿quién va a pagar?
No, yo, mi familia, yo soy la encargada de reservar.
Y como en mi caso soy la única, entonces solo yo la hago. ¿Verdad? Entonces, pero no sé usted, Julia.
Fíjese que yo no suelo salir así a quedarme fuera, pero si saliera quizás sería mi familia. Mi familia se encargaría de hacer la reservación.
Bueno, quizás en el suyo tendría que decir usual my, pero su familia sería su
mi hermana.
Su hermana.
Mi hermana.
Usually my sister makes, ahí sería con S, ¿verdad? Makes.
Yes.
Makes. ¿Por qué, teacher?
Estamos hablando de otra persona.
Ah.
Y esa persona es singular, ya sea él o ella. Si estuviéramos hablando, por ejemplo, de dos personas al mismo tiempo, ya sería ellos. Entonces ahí sería make, el verbo no llevaría S.
Porque es ella si lleva la S.
That's right.
Y si queremos poner que nosotros siempre hacemos las reservaciones, puede ser algo así como I always make reservation.
Yes, that will be the correct.
Algo así. Mm-hmm.
I always make the reservation.
The reservation.
The reservation.
La primera, teacher, le hemos puesto yes, I prefer to stay in an antique hotel.
Okay, very good.
Así se pronuncia, antique.
Yes, antique.
Antique.
Mm-hmm. Antique. Del antiguo.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, very good.
Y aquí se utiliza la S al final, así como está en la pregunta, hotels, o es solo hotel.
It will be antique hotel, porque es uno nada más, al menos que usted prefiera siempre quedarse en los hoteles antiguos, so it can be, I prefer to stay in a hotel. Sí, es que depende de lo que quiera dar a entender también, depende de la oración, si solo se refiere a uno o se refiere a dos. Acuérdese que hotel es singular y hotels es plural. I prefer antique hotels o I prefer a antique hotel. Ok, ya depende de lo que usted quiera comunicar. Podría ser de las dos formas. Ok, let's go back to the main room. Yes, I'm sorry. I always forget that. Okay. We're going to go over to the questions. So the first question, do you prefer to stay in a modern or antique hotel when you travel? ¿Qué es lo que prefiere? ¿Modern or antique?
Teacher.
Yes.
In my case, it depends to the place and visit.
Okay.
Because I prefer an antique hotel and I visit the forest.
Okay, very good. So you prefer an antique hotel when you go or when you travel to the forest or nearby the forest. Okay, very good. What about the rest? ¿Qué me dicen los demás? Yes.
Yes, I prefer the antique hotels.
You prefer the antique hotel too?
Mm-hmm. Oh. That depends. If I going to stay in the city, I prefer the modern.
Okay.
But if I going to stay in a country, I prefer the antique.
Okay, yeah. Very good. So when you go to the countryside, so afuera de la ciudad, so you prefer antique hotels. Very good. Okay, let's move on to the second question. Do you usually make your hotel reservations or someone else does it for you? Yes.
Teacher.
Yes, Joel.
I don't make a reservation.
You don't make the reservation. Someone else does it for you. Alguien más lo hace por usted.
No. Anybody.
Anybody. So you don't make any reservations, no or nobody?
Nope.
Okay, very good. Okay, Tatiana, what do you think? What can you answer number two, please?
Okay. I usually make the reservation.
Okay, very good. And sometimes we have someone does it for us when you get a touristic package, un paquete turístico. So those people made the reservation, right? So they offer the hotel and also the shuttle service and any other service that is included in the package. Very good. Okay, so we're going to move on to a conversation. And this is regarding the hotel or hotel reservation. Okay, this is about Jen and Gerardo. Okay, we're going to go over to this one and then we're going to practice this conversation. Okay. Hello, thank you for calling the Golden Star Hotel. This is Jen, how can I help you? Hello, I need to make a reservation. Sure, may I have your name please? Of course, I'm Gerardo Gomez. Thank you, Mr. Gomez. When are you going to arrive? I'm going to arrive on Friday 14th. How long are you going to stay with us, Mr. Gomez? I'm going to stay until Monday. Are you going to make the reservation for single or double room? A single room, please. Okay, questions about vocabulary. No questions?
Es que no puso la...
okay.
Es que
yes.
The libro, ¿verdad?
Yes, it's from the book. Page 41. No questions about vocabulary? Okay, very good. So there's no question. So we're going to practice this one. Okay, please repeat after me. Hello, thank you for calling the Golden Star Hotel.
Hello, thank you for calling the Golden Star Hotel.
This is Jen. How can I help you?
This is Jen. How can I help you?
Hello, I need to make a reservation.
Hello, I need a reservation.
Sure. May I have your name, please?
Sure. May I have your name, please?
Of course. I'm Gerardo Gomez.
Of course, I'm Gerardo Gomez.
Thank you, Mr. Gomez.
Thank you, Mr. Gomez.
When are you going to arrive?
When are you going to arrive?
I'm going to arrive on Friday 14th.
I'm going on Friday 14th.
How long are you going to stay with us, Mr. Gomez?
How long are you going to stay with us, Mr. Gomez?
I'm going to stay until Monday.
I'm going to stay until Monday.
Are you going to make the reservation for single or double room?
Are you going to make a reservation for a single room?
A single room, please.
A single room, please.
Thank you, Jenny, for joining us. We are practicing the conversation on page 41. Okay, don't worry, that's fine. Okay, so we're going to practice this. I am Jen and you are Gerardo. Hello, thank you for calling the Golden Star Hotel. This is Jen. How can I help you?
Hello, I need to make a reservation.
Sure. May I have your name, please?
Of course. I am Gerardo Gomez.
Thank you, Mr. Gomez. When are you going to arrive?
I'm going to arrive Friday 14.
How long are you going to stay with us, Mr. Gomez?
I'm going to stay until Monday.
Are you going to make the reservation for a single or a double room?
A single room, please.
Very good. Now, we're not going to practice this conversation in pairs, but I'm going to say who's going to practice this. I will model the conversation. You need to use your names. Please use your names. Okay, Jenny, you are Gerardo and I'm Jen. Okay, I'm the agent. But you need to, when I ask you, what is your name? You need to say, I am Jenny Quesada, okay? So, hello, thank you for calling the Golden Star Hotel. This is Frank, how can I help you?
Hello, I need to make a reservation.
Sure, may I have your name, please?
Of course, I am Jenny Quesada.
Thank you, Ms. Quesada. Where are you going to arrive?
I'm going to arrive on Friday 14th.
How long are you going to stay with us, Ms. Quesada?
I'm going to stay Monday.
Until Monday.
Until Monday.
Are you going to make the reservation for a single room, for a single or a double room?
A single room, please.
Very good. Okay, now Carla and Joel. Carla is Jen and Joel is Gerardo, but remember to use your names.
Okay.
Hello, thank you for calling at the Golden Star Hotel. This is Carla. How can I help you?
Hello, I need to make a reservation.
Sure. May I have your name, please?
Of course. I'm Joel Carrillo.
Thank you, Mr. Carrillo. Where are you going to arrive?
I'm going to arrive on Friday 14th.
How long are you going to stay with us, Mr. Castillo?
I'm going to stay until Monday.
Are you going to make the reservation for a single or a double room?
A single room, please.
Okay, very good. Okay, now we're going to have Tatiana and Erica. Erica will be Jen and Tatiana will be Gerardo.
Hello. Thank you for calling the Golden Stereo Hotel. This is Erica. How can I help you?
Hello. I need to make a reservation.
Sure. May I have your name, please?
Of course. I'm Tatiana Flores.
Thank you, Miss Flores. When are you going to arrive?
I'm going to arrive on Friday 14.
How long are you going to stay with us, Miss
Flores?
I'm going to stay until Monday.
Are you going to make the reservation for single or double room?
A single room, please.
Very good. Okay, now we have Flor and Julia. Flor is Jen and Julia is Gerardo.
Hello, thank you for calling the Golden Star Hotel. This is Jen. How can I help you?
Your name. This is, and you need to use your name. This is Flor.
Okay. Okay. This is Flor. How can I help you?
Very good.
Hello, I need to make a reservation.
Sure. May I have your name, please?
Of course, I am Julia Monge.
Thank you, Miss Monge. When are you going to arrive?
I'm going to arrive on Friday 14.
How long?
Ay, perdone que se me va la señal de repente.
Okay.
How long are you going to stay with us, Miss Monge?
I'm going to stay until Monday.
Are you going to make the reservation for a single or a double room?
A single room, please.
Okay, very good. Now we're going to have Carlos and Jenny. Jenny, in this case, you are Jen, and Carlos, you will be Gerardo.
Dígame.
Until es hasta.
Hasta, okay. Thank you.
En este caso sería, me voy a quedar hasta el lunes.
Okay. Ready, Carlos?
Yes.
Okay. Hello. Thank you for calling the Golden Star Hotel. This is Jenny. Can I help you?
Hello. I need to make a reservation.
Sure. May I have your name, please?
Of course. I am Carlos Contreras.
Thank you, Mr. Contreras. When are you going to arrive?
I'm going to arrive on Friday 14.
How long are you going to stay with us, Mr. Contreras?
I'm going to stay until Monday.
Are you going to make the reservation for a single or a double room?
A single room, please.
Very good, guys. Very good. Okay, so let's move, and we're going to do activity number 3 together. So if you see here, let me just to put the mouse here. We have the Star Hotel reservation form. The agent, who is the agent in this case?
Jen.
Jen. Okay, so write Jen here. Okay, who is the guest?
Gerardo.
Gerardo. Very good. So we have agent, Jen, guest, Gerardo. Check in.
And Friday 14.
Very good. That is the Friday 14. Okay, so what is the checkout?
Monday, that's it.
Monday, so y si contamos que Friday es 14, we 15, have Saturday 16, 15, so Monday, that's 17. Very good. What is the room that he book?
A single room.
Very good. Okay, so if we move on, any questions about this? No. Okay, if we move on to number four. So we use would you like for a very polite request. Need or want are also possible, but less polite. Okay, si yo digo I need a room, puede ser un poco amable. So estoy llamando porque necesito un cuarto, right? So I need to make a reservation for a room. I want a room, that's possible as well. Pero es menos cortés que would you like. Si queremos ser formales, we can say, would you like, for example, a question, would you like to have an ice cream or would you like to have a review tomorrow about the grammatical structures we covered during the course? Si le estoy preguntando bien amable, si quisieran un repaso de todas las estructuras gramaticales que hemos visto. Would you like to have? Okay, if you see, we like to have a room, a single or a double room in this case. If you doing that in a polite way. Very good. So, any question? ¿Alguna pregunta sobre estas actividades? ¿No hay preguntas? Carla? No? Okay, very good. Okay, so let's move on. I will share a conversation, another conversation, but with the audio. Okay, so what we're going to do right now, before sharing the conversation, I will share this part. Let me see if you see the screen. ¿La ven?
Ya la quitó.
No. Okay. Let me see porque no había compartido el audio. Okay. Now, can you see the screen? Yes?
Okay. I see two screen.
Okay, very good. So if you see, we have the months and dates. Okay, en español es lo usual, es nada más decir el número uno como primero.
First. Okay,
de ahí en español decimos primero de mayo, primero de junio, primero de abril y so on. De ahí para decir dos decimos dos y de ahí nos vamos 3, 4, 5 hasta el 31. Pero en inglés son son los que cambian, básicamente cuatro. Sería first, que es este, second, third. Y el quinto, que es fifth. De ahí todos va con fourth, sixth, va con una Z al final. En vez de decir four, digo fourth. En vez de decir six, digo sixth, con una Z al final. Seventh,
sixth,
eighth, ninth, tenth, eleventh, twelfth, thirteenth, fourteenth, y así so on. Cuando llegamos al 1, al 2 y al 3, decimos first, second, and third. De ahí volvemos con Z, fourth, y el quinto sería fifth. No sería con Z, sino que fifth, con F al final. Que son cuatro pronunciaciones diferentes. First, second, third, and fifth. Y de ahí los demás solo se le agrega la Z al final. Ok, Eso es con los dates. Now, con los months. Let's practice this. Let's listen. And then we're going to practice the month. Esto es para que tengan una idea. Nos estamos alejando un poquito fuera de la estructura, pero está incluido. Si ustedes se fijan, en cuando hacemos un third reservation, mencionan dates, el mes y el día. So we need to learn this. Okay, let's listen to this and then we're going to practice.
Unit 11. What are you going to do? Page 72, exercise 1. Months and dates. Part A. Listen and practice the months.
January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December.
Okay, now we're going to practice this. And we're going to repeat after the audio.
Part A, listen and practice the months.
January.
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 February.
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 March.
March. March.
April.
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 May.
May.
June.
June.
July.
July.
August.
August.
September.
September.
October.
October.
November.
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 December.
December.
December. One more time.
April.
Okay, just let me just okay.
Months and dates. Part A. Listen and practice the months.
January.
January.
February.
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 March.
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 April.
April.
May.
May.
June.
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 July.
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 August.
August.
September.
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 October.
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 November.
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 December.
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 Okay, very good. Now, Carlos, can you tell us all the month? Now we're going to practice. Okay, si tiene problemas con pronunciar algo, me puede preguntar. Por eso no hay ningún problema. Empezamos con Carlos.
Okay.
January.
January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December.
Okay, please repeat May.
May.
June.
June.
July.
July.
September.
September.
November.
November.
Once again, May.
May.
June.
June.
July.
July.
September.
September.
November.
November.
Very good. Julia, your turn.
January. February. March. April. May. June. July. August. September. October. November, December.
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 December. Very good. Carla, your turn.
Okay.
May, January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December.
Very good. December. Tatiana, your turn, please.
January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December.
Very good. Flora, you're torn.
January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December.
Okay, it is September. Please repeat.
September.
October. October. November.
November.
December.
December.
Very good. Como que es el, se acentúa más la voz en la segunda sílaba. September. October.
September.
November. December. En la mayor fuerza de voz va en la segunda sílaba. Como okay. Que va aquí, baja, está abajo, sube en la segunda y vuelve a bajar ya en las demás. Ok. Very good, Flor. Jenny, your turn.
January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December.
Very good. Erica, your turn. Tiene el, okay.
January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December.
Very good. Joel, your turn. Staying muted, Joel. Okay.
Sorry, teacher.
Don't worry.
Okay. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, and December.
Okay, please repeat. September.
September.
October.
October.
November.
November.
And December.
December.
Once again, September.
September.
October.
October.
November.
November.
December.
December.
Very good. So okay. La mayor fuerza de voz va en la segunda sílaba. September.
September.
Que okay, está abajo. September. October. October. November. December. Y va. Okay. Okay. Very good.
Thank you.
Welcome. Ok, voy a hacer una pausa ahorita para tomar lista. Que ayer se me fue la picucha en tomar lista a esta hora. Ok, so remember to say present and we're going to start with Eduardo Antonio Ángel Martínez, Jenny Quesada Fernández de Campos.
Present.
Jenny Alexandra Montenegro Galdames, Sergio Alberto Sosa Santos, Mónica Guadalupe Martínez Munguía, José Ernesto Rivera Deras, Wendy Joana Estrada Escobar, Andrés Oswaldo Ramos Cepeda, Eduardo Alfredo Pérez Rugamas, Tatiana Flores.
Present.
Thank you very much. Carla Evelyn Meléndez Guzmán.
Present.
Thank you very much. Erika Paulina Rivera Llanes.
Present.
Thank you very much. Maritza Elizabeth Chicas Villalta. Mariela Lourdes Amaya Herrera. Flor Morena Rodríguez de Morales.
Present.
Thank you very much. Carlos Emilio Contreras Romero.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much. Dora Ayala de López, Emma Carolina Araniva Sarabia, Daniel Edgardo Álvarez Hernández y Julia Carolina Monje Rodríguez.
Present.
Thank you very much. Y tenemos José Joel Carrillo Payés.
Thank you, teacher.
Welcome.
I remember that.
Okay, very good.
Thank you.
Welcome. Okay, so we're going to continue with the activity. As you saw, we just covered the month, right? So now we go to the dates. So we're going to listen and then we're going to practice. No lo vamos a practicar todos en sí, como lo hicimos con los meses, porque nos va a llevar bastante tiempo. Solo vamos a practicar dos veces y voy a elegir algunos días y ustedes me van a decir cómo se dice. Okay, first of all, listen.
Page 72, exercise 1, part B. Complete the dates, then listen and practice.
First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th, 19th, 20th, 21st, 22nd, 23rd, 24th, 25th, 26th, 27th, 28th, 29th, 30th, 31st.
Okay, very good. So we're going to practice after the audio.
Second.
Okay, just wait. Okay.
First.
First.
Second.
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 Third.
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 Fourth.
Fourth.
Fifth.
Fourth.
Fifth.
Fifth.
Fifth. Fifth.
Sixth.
Sixth. Sixth.
Seventh.
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 Eighth.
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 Ninth.
Ninth.
Si quieres tomar, yo me tomo uno.
Tenth.
Tenth. Tenth.
Eleventh.
Eleventh.
Twelfth.
Twelfth.
Thirteenth.
Fourteenth.
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 15th.
15th.
16th. 17th.
17th.
18th.
18th.
19th.
19th.
20th.
20th.
21st. 21st.
22nd.
22nd.
23rd.
23rd.
24th.
24th.
25th.
25th.
26th.
26th.
27th.
27th.
28th.
28th.
29th.
29th.
30th.
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 31st.
31st.
31st. Okay, if you see, no sé si ven el puntero.
Yeah.
Okay. If you see, we have first, second, third. Fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. Esto prácticamente se repite cuando llegamos al 20. Si ustedes se fijan, 20th, 21st, 22nd, 23rd, 24th, 25th, 26th, 27th, 28th, 29th. Y de ahí llegamos al 30, donde decimos 30th, 30th. No es que les esté sacando la lengua. Soy mal educado, solo les estoy enseñando how you do it. 30th. Okay, 30th. Okay, then we have 31st. De ahí,
31st.
Es 11th, siempre va a ir con sonido Z al final. 11th. 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, and so on. Hasta que llegamos al 19th. Después llegamos 20th.
20.
Y empezamos. 21st, igual 20th. Que empecemos con los demás. Okay, so let's do this. Vamos a pasar a esta parte. When is your birthday? Okay. I can say it's okay. I will start. It's August. Okay, it's August 5th. Okay, now Carlos, when is your birthday?
It's June 14th.
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 Very good. Okay. Julia, when is your birthday?
Is June 9th. 9th.
9th.
9th.
Very good. Carla, when is your birthday?
January 31st.
Okay, very good. Tatiana, when is your birthday?
It's April 2nd.
Second, very good. Flor, when is your birthday?
March
31st. Okay. Very good, Marina. Jenny, when is your birthday? Tiene, okay.
It's February 22nd.
Very good. Erica, when is your birthday?
It's January 14th.
Después de la in, le agrega la Z. 14th. Very good. Joel, when is your birthday?
May 5th.
May 5th. Okay, 5th. Very good. Okay, so do you have any questions about this? About the month and dates? Acuérdense que no vamos a utilizar, no vamos a decir May 1. Tenemos que decir May 1st. No podemos decir May 2, ok, sino que decimos May 2nd. No podemos decir May 3, sino que decimos May 3rd. Ok, aquí utilizamos los cardinal numbers. Ok, very good. There's no question. Let's move on to this conversation. I will zoom in. No sé si está bien. ¿Pueden ver la conversación bien?
Yes.
Okay. I will play the audio and you will follow the conversation.
Page 72, exercise 2, conversation. Birthday plans. Listen and practice.
Are you gonna do anything exciting this weekend?
Well, I'm gonna celebrate my birthday.
Oh, happy birthday. When is it exactly?
It's August 9th, Sunday.
So what are your plans?
I'm gonna go to my friend Kayla's house. She's gonna cook a special dinner for me.
Nice. Is she gonna bake a cake too?
Bake a cake? Oh, I'm not sure.
Okay, very good. Do you have any questions about vocabulary?
Teacher,
yes.
¿Por qué usa el bake a cake?
Bake es hornear.
Yeah.
So going to bake a cake. Va a hornear un pastel. Pastel.
Exactly. ¿Cómo se pronuncia?
Exactly. 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 Exactly.
La T no suena.
¿Cómo no se exactly?
Exactly.
Exactly. Exactly. Any other question? Básicamente se pronuncian todas las letras. Exactly. Exactly. No more questions? Okay, very good. Let's practice this conversation. Okay, so we're going to do this. Joel, you are Philip and I'm Angie. Are you going to do anything special? Excuse me, are you going to do anything exciting this weekend?
Well, I'm going to celebrate my birthday.
Oh, happy birthday. When is it exactly?
It's August 9th, Sunday.
So what are you what are your plans?
I'm going to go to my friend Kayla's house. She's going to cook a special dinner for me.
Nice. Is she going to bake a cake too?
Bake a cake? Oh, I'm not sure.
Very good. Okay, Jenny and Carlos. Carlos is Philip and Jenny is Angie.
Are you going to do anything exactly this weekend?
Carlos?
Well, I am going to celebrate my birthday.
Okay. Oh, happy birthday. When is exactly?
It's January 14th.
Ay, la conversación se borró.
Okay. I'm sorry.
So, what are your plans?
I am going to go to my friend Kayla's house. She is going to cook a special dinner for me.
Nice. Is she going to bake a cake too?
Bake a cake? Oh, I'm not sure.
Okay, very good. Okay, Julia is going to be Angie and Carla is going to be Philip.
Teacher, la veo algo extendida la imagen.
Déjame ver.
Ah, ya. Bye. Ya. Okay. Sí. Are you going to do anything existing this weekend?
Exciting.
This exciting. Weekend. Exciting this weekend?
Well, I'm going to celebrate my birthday.
Oh, happy birthday. When is it exactly?
It's August 9th, Sunday.
So what are your plans?
I'm going to go to my friend Kayla's house. She's going to cook a special dinner for me.
Nice. Is she going to bake a cake too?
Bake a cake? I'm not sure.
Very good. Okay, Tatiana is going to be Angie and Flor will be Philip.
Are you going to do anything exciting this weekend?
Well, I'm going to celebrate my birthday.
Oh, happy birthday. When is it exactly?
It's August 9th, Sunday.
So what are your plans?
I'm going to go to my friend Kayla's house. She's going to cook a special dinner for me.
Nice. Is she going to bake a cake too?
Bake a cake? Oh, I'm not sure.
Very good. Okay, Erica, you will be Angie and I will be Philip.
Are you going to anything exciting this weekend?
Well, I'm going to celebrate my birthday.
Oh, happy birthday. When is the exactly?
It's August 9th, Sunday.
So what are your plans?
I'm going to go to my friend Kyla's house. She's going to cook a special dinner for me.
Nice. She going to bake a cake too?
Bake a cake? Oh, I'm not sure. Okay, very good, guys. So basically, if I want just to highlight this thing, if you see, we use, are you going to do anything? So the structure here is the be going to. La estructura aquí se llama be going to. ¿Para qué sirve? We make plans. Are you going to do anything exciting this weekend? Well, I'm going to celebrate my birthday. ¿Cuál es el plan de Philip? Celebrar el cumpleaños. Okay, very good. So if you go to this part in Philip's, I'm going to go to my friend Kyla's house. If you see, that is the plan for Sunday. Okay, very good. So you will see that more clearly in this part. Okay, let me just zoom in. Do you see the screen very well? Do you read it? ¿Lo leen bien? Okay. Okay, para formar el presente continuo necesitamos dos cosas. Necesitamos el verbo be, que en este caso es am, is o are. Aquí en la oración está contractado. I am, she is, and they are, o there. Pero básicamente necesitamos dos cosas. Sería el verbo be más going to, más el verbo en su estado normal, o sea, no la forma base. Ok, if you see the question, acuérdese que para hacer la pregunta nada más cambiamos el verbo be al principio y el sujeto lo pasamos después. So, in this case, are you going to do anything this weekend? Yes, I am. I'm going to celebrate my birthday. No, I'm not. I'm going to stay home. Second question, is Kyla going to cook dinner for you? Yes, she is. She's going to cook a special dinner. No, she's not. She's going to order a takeout. Are your friends going to be there? Yes, they are. They're going to stop by after dinner. No, they're not. They're going to be away all weekend. If you see, so we use the verb be plus going to plus the base form of the verb. ¿Alguna pregunta sobre esta, sobre esto? ¿Está claro? ¿Es clear? ¿O necesita un poco más de explicación? ¿O un ejemplo que podamos hacer todos juntos?
Yes.
Así es, el futuro se utiliza para un futuro, pero haciendo planes, ya cuando algo está planeado. Ok. Por ejemplo, tomorrow we are going to have the one-on-one. El día de mañana ya está planeado, vamos a tener la sesión de uno a uno, right? So that is a plan. So that's why I'm use going to. ¿Estamos claros? ¿O necesitamos un poquito más de explicación? Clear? Así pasamos al ejercicio. Okay. So the exercise for this. ¿Qué es lo que vamos a hacer? Vamos a utilizar el be going to. Utilizándolo en estas en estas fotos. Acuérdense, en este caso ya está hecha. They are or they're going to go dancing. Volunteer for number two. ¿Qué sería? Okay, very good. He's going to read a book. Number three, volunteer.
He's going to swim.
Okay, very good. Number four.
She's going to walk.
Very good. Number five.
They are going to play tennis.
Very good. They are going to play tennis. Number six. Volunteer for number six.
Está comprando, ¿verdad?
Yes. She's going to buy jewelry. Para ponerle, agregarle Boy. El que la va a comprar. Very good. Number seven.
They're going to go to the movie theater.
Very good. They are going to go to the movie theater. Very good. Number eight.
He's going to call his brother.
Very good job, guys. Now, let's go over to the textbook. And let's do this part. I will share this one. Okay, so we're going to work in this part. Let me share this. Okay, if you see, we have the explanation here. Okay, tenemos un poco de la explicación un poquito más detallada. Si usted se fija en las afirmativas, vamos a utilizar, excuse me, el verbo be. I am going to arrive. I am going to stay. Miss Puentes is going to travel. Si la queremos hacer negativa, solo vamos a poner el verbo be en negativo. El going to se mantiene, el verbo se mantiene en su forma base. Solo va a ser lo primero que vamos a modificar. So Miss Puentes is not. Si ustedes se fijan de aquí para acá, going to fly, se mantiene igual. Miss Gómez is not going to arrive. Ok, eso es. Yes.
En el caso de la primera persona, dice I'm going to arrive. Sería para la función negativa, I'm not going to arrive.
Very good.
Ok, thank you.
Welcome. So we use this in negative. Now, para hacerla como una pregunta, acuérdense que solo van a mover el verbo be. Si ustedes se fijan, tienen el sujeto I y el verbo be am. Entonces, ¿qué es lo que va a hacer? Esto lo va a pasar para el principio y esto, el sujeto va a pasar en segundo lugar. If you see, are you going to stay? El going to stay se va a mantener. Going to más el verbo base no va a cambiar. Solo que va a cambiar de posición es el verbo, que en este caso el verbo be, y el sujeto. Are you going to make a reservation for a single or double room? Now, para las information questions, acuérdense, cuando son preguntas abiertas, siempre va a ir la question word. Where, how, why, what, where, when, who, how. Those are the question words. Then we have the verb be in this case, then the subject, and then we have going to plus the verb. How long are you going to stay? When are you going to arrive? If you see, so we use the question word first, then the verb be, then the subject, then going to plus the verb. ¿Alguna pregunta?
Teacher.
Yes.
When we use the going to, the verb is queda normal, no lo cambio.
No se cambia.
Okay.
Okay. Very good. So what we're going to do, ¿hay alguna pregunta antes de hacer la actividad número 5? No. Okay, we're going to do this in pairs. Okay, so we need to order the words to create the sentences or questions about schedule activities. If you have, we have number one already done. To Dallas, you going to, when arrive are. So what is the correct order? When are you going to arrive to Dallas? You can do the same with the 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, we're going to work in pairs. Let me do the pairs. Vamos a hacer las parejas. Okay, so let's do Carlos and Tatiana. We have Erica and Joel. We have Floor and Jenny, and we have Julia and Carla. So we're going to work on activity number 5. Solo la actividad número 5, van a ordenar las preguntas o u oraciones. Okay, and then we're going to shake those together. Let's work right now. Yes. Flor, Carlos y Erika, could you please click on para entrar? Okay, thank you. Joel, me iba a decir algo.
Sí, teacher, no logré capturar la conversación. Bueno, las preguntas para.
Okay, I will share that one y me avisa.
Okay.
Ahí está.
Okay. Vamos a trabajar con la número 5, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Okay, welcome.
Okay, vamos a empezar.
Sería la 2, sería
dice sala de conferencias. Son reservas. Sería.
Are you no sé. No sé si sería are you going to a reservation for a conference room? No sé si sería así.
For a reservation, man.
Are you going to a reservation?
May conference room.
A reservation
conference
for,
room.
For? For the conferences room.
For the conferences room. ¿Qué haría entonces? Are you going to for? Ah, no, May.
Very good.
May for a reservation the conference room.
Mm-hmm.
Very good.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
¿La copió?
Sí,
¿la
tiene? Sí, sí, sí.
Reservation for conference room. La otra es I am, tiene que empezar con I am. I am.
I think. I going to. A request.
¿Sí? I call is
wake up call 5 a.m. sería. Entonces quedaría así. I'm going to a request for wake up call 5 a.m.
Ok. Uh-huh. Acuérdense, sí, sí. Acuérdense que request es el verbo. No iría a request. Sería, I'm going to request.
I'm going to request.
Ajá.
For wake up call.
Sería, en vez de, si usted le puso la a request, solo traslade la A después de request.
A for.
Awake.
I'm going to request.
¿Qué es lo que va a pedir? ¿Cuál es el servicio que va a pedir?
Yo quiero solicitar que me levanten a las 5 de la mañana. I wake up call.
A wake up call for 5 a.m. Very good. Continue and I will move on to another group, another pair.
I wake up call.
Mis socios is going. Going to check out. Tomorrow.
Check out tomorrow.
Entonces, the my name's team is going to attend the conference on October 5th. No, 10th.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm. Entonces, es the my name's team. ¿Cuál es el verbo en todas esas palabras?
Attend.
Ajá. You're going to attend.
Attend.
¿Qué es a dónde es que van a asistir?
A la conferencia.
Ajá.
Eso sería on.
To attend.
To attend a conference.
Very good. ¿Cuándo?
Es que la, el, las fechas, no es decir que las fechas siempre van, antes de las fechas se pone un on.
Very good.
O in, creo. No.
No, es on. Cuando tenemos fechas específicas, tenemos mes y día, es on. Si solo tenemos el mes, sería in. Y sería in October, quitándole la fecha, que sería el 10. Pero si tenemos el mes y el día, sería on. Por eso está ahí, on October 10th.
Vaya, entonces el día la completa, ¿cómo le quedaría?
The maintenance team is going to attend a conference on October 10th.
Very good.
Vaya la otra. Yo creo que lo más fácil primero, bueno, yo lo primero que hago es identificar el verbo.
Yes, it's very easy to do that.
Y después empiezo a ver quién
va a ser. Ahí comenzaríamos con mis días. Mis días is going to Miss Diaz is going to need no smoking room o al revés.
No, al revés, porque después del going to va el verbo, no puede ir otra palabra más que solo un verbo.
Ah, entonces sería no es, sería need. Entonces sería Miss Diaz is going to. Need no smoking room.
No smoking room. Ahora traten de hacer esa esa en pregunta. ¿Cómo sería? Para que practiquemos la cómo hacer la pregunta.
Very good.
Very good. Solo va a trasladar el verbo be al principio y va a cambiar mis días a segundo lugar. Solo ese cambio va a ser para hacer una pregunta, right? Okay, very good. So I'm going to give one more minute because some other couples has not finished yet. Just 1 minute.
Okay.
You finish?
No.
Not yet. Okay, you have one more minute.
Cinco, teacher.
Okay, don't worry, that's fine.
Okay, okay. Ahí sería.
The maintenance team is going to then.
Yes.
Hola, teacher.
Hello, hello.
En las 5 tenemos duda.
Dígame. Ajá. ¿Cómo la tiene?
Hasta ahorita la hemos hecho así. Is a conference going to attend on October 10th, the maintenance team.
Ok. Vaya. Hay que identificar cuál es el sujeto.
Ellos.
El equipo de mantenimiento.
Ajá. Hagámoslo primero oración. Hagamos la oración primero para después hacer la pregunta. Entonces sería primero el sujeto, sería maintenance team.
Ah, ok.
Ok, después
va, estamos mal.
Va verbo be, después va going to y después va el verbo en su forma base. ¿Cómo quedaría hasta ahí por el momento?
Maintenance is going to.
Ajá, ¿y cuál sería el verbo?
Okay.
Ten. Ok, very good. ¿A dónde van a asistir?
The conference.
Very good. ¿Cuándo?
October.
On October 10.
Very good. Entonces, ¿cómo quedaría?
the maintenance team is going to the conference.
Falta el verbo. Is going to.
Ten.
Ajá.
Siempre me pierden las palabritas.
The conference.
The conference.
October.
On October 10th. Very good. Ahora, para hacer la pregunta, solo van a cambiar el verbo be y el sujeto. ¿Cómo sería?
Is the maintenance team going to attend the conference on October 10th?
Very good.
Okay.
Okay, so we're going to move on. It doesn't matter if you have not finished. Vamos a ver cómo tenemos las todas las oraciones o preguntas. Y vamos a regresar ahorita al main room.
Okay, teacher, thank you.
Welcome. Okay, very good, guys. So right now we go over, some of you probably have questions and some of you have sentences in order just to practice this. Okay, so we have number two. Volunteer for number two.
Are you going to make a reservation for conference rooms?
Okay, are you going to make a reservation for the conference room? Okay, that is a question. Very good. Okay, we have number three. Volunteer for number three. Carla, do you have number three?
¿Cómo quedó esa teacher? Perdón.
Jenny la hizo como pregunta. Are you going to make a reservation for the conference room? ¿Cómo la tienen ustedes, Carla? ¿Ustedes la tienen como oración o como pregunta?
Como oración.
¿Qué tiene?
Are you going to make for a reservation the conference room?
Ok, sería, esa cuando empieza con are es una pregunta. Entonces quedaría como la dijo Jenny. Are you going to make a reservation for the conference room? That will be the correct question.
Ok.
Ok, Carla, number three, thank you.
I'm going to request a wake-up call for 5 a.m.
Very good. I'm going to request a wake-up call for 5 a.m. Very good. Number four. Julia, do you have number four?
Ms. Turchers is going to check tomorrow.
Very good. Ms. Turchers is going to check out tomorrow. Very good. Number five, Erica, please.
Is the main team is going to attend the conference October 10th.
Very good. The maintenance team is going to attend a conference on October 10th. Very good. Number six, Tatiana, do you have number six?
Esa no la hice, teacher.
Okay, no problem. Volunteer for number six. Carla, do you have number six?
Is Miss Diaz going to need a non-smoking room?
Very good. Okay. Do you have any question regarding that? ¿Alguna pregunta sobre eso?
Teacher, yo la hice con Mr. Diaz going to need is a non-smoking room.
Okay, si la ponemos como oración sería Miss Diaz is going to need a non-smoking room. Se puede ya sea como pregunta o como una oración. Lo único que hay que tener cuidado cuando es pregunta, el verbo be va a ir al principio. y el sujeto va a ir en segundo. Sí.
¿Cómo quedaría si fuera pregunta? Is going to need.
No, is Miss Díaz.
Ah, okay.
Going to need a non-smoking room.
Okay. Dicho en la número 5, yo la dejé como pregunta.
No importa. O sea, si puso el verbo al principio, uh-huh, sería como pregunta. Is the main team going to attend conference room on October 10th? Está correcto. O sea, ahí depende si usted lo quería hacer como pregunta o lo quería hacer como una oración.
Ajá, se puede usar de ambas formas, como no estaba la question mark ahí en medio.
Ajá, como no estaba la question mark, no nos indicaba si era pregunta o era una oración. Entonces ahí ustedes decidían si la querían hacer. Si la tiene como is the main team going to attend a conference on October the 10th, está correcto. Pero tiene que ir el verbo be primero, is.
Okay.
Y de ahí el sujeto.
Teacher.
Okay. Yes.
Vaya, si es pregunta, la estructura sería como primero el be, luego el sujeto, going to y el verbo.
Ok, aquí se la voy a poner. La estructura. Primero tenemos el subject. Después va a ir el verbo be. Después we have going to. Then we have the verb. And we have the complement in some cases, right? Esta es la estructura de la oración. O sentence structure. We have example. Lo vamos a hacer todos juntos. Díganme un sujeto. Cualquier nombre, pues él o ella, ellos, it doesn't matter.
Sí.
We.
We. Ok, we. Verb be. Very good. Are. Después, ¿qué seguiría?
Going to.
Going to. Give me a verb.
Bye.
Bye. ¿Qué? Aquí sería el complemento.
Mm-hmm. Bye.
We're going to buy a hamburger.
Pizza.
Okay.
Pizza.
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 If you see.
Abunda más.
Yes. If you see, we is the subject. Are is the verb be. Going to, we have the going to. The verb in this case is buy. And the complement pizza. Now, in a negative sentence, ¿qué es lo que tenemos? We have the subject. Plus verb be. But in this case, we need to have it in negative. Plus going to. Let me just extend this. Plus the verb plus the complement. Okay, let's do the same sentence but in negative. ¿Cómo quedaría la misma oración en negativo?
We are not going to buy a pizza.
Very good. We are not going to buy pizza.
To buy pizza.
O lo podemos, esto, el we are not, lo podemos contractar.
We aren't we going to.
Aren't.
Uh-huh. We aren't.
We aren't.
Ok, podemos decir we are not o we aren't going to buy pizza.
La primera sería, ¿qué sería? Afirmativa.
La primera, sí, esta de acá sería afirmativa. Esta de acá sería la negativa. Ahora, a eso vamos. Ahora, para preguntas, ¿qué tenemos? Verb be. Last subject. Plus going to, plus verb, plus the complement in case there is a complement. No todas las preguntas llevan un complemento, right? So, for example, in this case, ¿cómo quedaría la misma oración en pregunta?
Are we going to buy a pizza?
If you see, that is very simple. ¿Y cómo se va a responder? Se va a responder con el verbo be. Yes, we are. No, we aren't. ¿Estamos? ¿Está claro?
Teacher, yes. Yo me levanté en ese momento. La última es para pregunta.
Así es.
Así, ya le dije, como la tengo bien lejos la imagen, no le veía la, la marca de la pregunta. Thank you, teacher.
Welcome. ¿Alguna pregunta, chicos? ¿Estamos claros? Si les paso un examen ahorita, ¿me lo contestan?
Ok.
Con todo, teacher, con todo.
Ok, very good. Ok, vamos a hacer un pequeño repaso de lo que aprendimos el día de ahora. Y después voy a dar algunas indicaciones. So, what do you remember about today? What vocabulary do we learn today? Did we learn today?
The going to.
Okay, the structure be going to. El rate. ¿Qué más?
El bake.
El bake. Very good.
Numbers.
Okay, the numbers. Okay, the card, the ordinal numbers. And also the
month.
Very good. ¿Qué más? ¿Para qué sirve? How do we use or what is the reason we use the be going to?
Porque, para el futuro.
Ok, utilizamos para un futuro, pero ¿qué clase de futuro?
Plans, future plans.
Ok, very good. When we have already a plan. Si no, nosotros decidimos algo ahorita, no es un plan. Mañana, por decir algo, voy a ir a comprar, mañana voy a ir al mercado. No es algo que tengo en mente ahorita. Ahorita se me acaba de ocurrir. Entonces no puedo utilizar el going to porque no es un plan. Pero ya es
entonces
un plan.
Sería,
I will go to the market tomorrow.
Ajá. Okay.
Vaya, si nosotros de lunes a viernes tenemos clases, ya está planeado. Que okay, mañana ya está planeado que vamos a tener clases. So, tomorrow we are going to have an English class. If you see, we are going to take, we are going to have, or any other verb, we are going to eat. Si ya hemos planeado qué es lo que vamos a comer. Si ya hemos planeado alguna actividad, ya sea para mañana o fin de semana o la otra semana. So you are going to buy, you are going to. That is the structure that we need to use. Ok, ¿alguna pregunta, duda, sugerencia respecto a la clase de ahora? No.
No.
Ok. Voy a dar indicaciones. Entre mañana y el jueves van a recibir una encuesta que sería la carta de satisfacción. Algunos ya conocen ese proceso que al finalizar el módulo siempre la empresa llena una carta de satisfacción del curso. Entonces, esa información se la van a mandar vía WhatsApp y vía email. Que en el dado caso, es los que chequean sobre el WhatsApp, ahí lo van a tener. O los que chequean sobre el email, ahí va a estar. pero solo una vez se va a llenar y lo vamos a hacer juntos el día viernes. Así es que no me vayan a llenar nada todavía porque el viernes se va a dar mayor información de cómo llenar esa encuesta. Ok, al finalizarle, yes.
Disculpe, el viernes sería la última clase.
Sí, el viernes es la última clase del módulo. Entonces estaba revisando el correo y tentativamente estaríamos empezando el 7 de septiembre, que sería, o sea, dentro de 2 semanas. Porque a más tardar el papeleo se tiene que entregar el 1 de septiembre. Para empezar, ahorita no está fijo, pero está tentativo el 7 de septiembre. Ok, con respecto, sí, dígame.
¿Se va a mantener usted en el grupo con nosotros o vamos a quedar desperdigados otra vez?
No sabría decirles porque depende de los que se inscriban. Así se va a abrir el grupo número 4. Hasta donde yo tengo entendido, hay algunas personas que se han quedado en el grupo número 3. O sea, que para iniciar el 4 no se inició anteriormente por el hecho de que no se llegó al total de alumnos para inscribir. Entonces, se necesita tener un grupo para poder continuar. Por eso se dice tentativo el 7. Probablemente esa fecha se puede mover. No estoy seguro y depende del proceso de inscripción. ¿Qué más les iba a decir sobre esto? Ah, que al final de la encuesta o de la carta de satisfacción les va a mostrar un mensaje que ya está completada su encuesta o su carta de satisfacción. A esa parte hay que tomarle una captura de pantalla. La pueden mandar directamente a Elena Méndez, a la señora, la teacher que puso la información ahora temprano, o la pueden mandar directamente o al grupo también. O sea, no hay problema, directamente a ella o al grupo. Ok. Con las tareas. Siempre voy a insistir en esto. Y a partir de mañana, un poquito, voy a tomar un poquito más de tiempo. Mucho, unos 5 minutos más. Voy a compartir un documento en el cual he pegado las preguntas de la tarea. Ok, básicamente solo son 4 o 5 preguntas en cada tarea. Entonces, no sé si pueden abrir su plataforma en la tarea número 16 para que todos, solo vamos a tomar 5 minutos más para poder, porque se está dando el problema que no todos me están completando las tareas. Entonces vamos a tomar 5 minutos después de la clase para revisar si tienen alguna pregunta. Y ustedes lo hacen junto, lo hacemos juntos para que todo esté bien. Entonces, no sé si se ve completamente la pantalla o necesita que lo ponga más grande. Ok, aquí vamos. Ok, en esta tarea lo que hay que hacer es nada más seleccionar. Aquí es base a vocabulario que vimos el día de ayer. No hay que llenar nada, o sea, no hay que estar escribiendo absolutamente nada. Ahora, aquí dice instructions, read the following sentence and complete with the best answer. ¿Cómo quedaría la primera? A place, such a room in a hotel where travelers can sleep and find other services. ¿Cómo quedaría esa? Amenities or accommodations? Accommodation.
Accommodation.
Okay, very good. Accommodation. Okay. Number 2. The features of the hotel that are available for guests to use. Example, a gym, a pool, a minibar, a jacuzzi, etc. Those are amenities or accommodation?
Amenities.
Very good. Amenities.
Amenities.
Very good. Number three, a non-smoking room means people may smoke or people may not smoke.
People may not smoke.
Very good. People may not smoke. Okay, so number four, a shuttle service is your own transportation or transportation from the hotel.
Transportation from the hotel.
Very good. Transportation from the hotel. To book a room is to read in a room or to make a reservation.
To make a reservation.
Si ustedes se fijan, solo es el vocabulario que vimos el día de ayer. No toma más de 3 minutos. Ok. Vamos a ir a la tarea del día de ahora. Ok. So, complete the sentences using the form of be plus going to plus the verb in brackets. Aquí nada más es de completar. No hay que poner toda la oración de nuevo. ¿Cómo sería aquí? He. Vamos a utilizar esto de acá. ¿Qué va a ir primero?
Is.
Very good. He is. Ajá.
Going to.
Ajá.
By the phone.
Going to phone. Going to phone. His friend. Ok, nada más lo que van a poner en el espacio es esto. Es hasta phone. Eso es lo que van a poner en el espacio. Number two.
Teacher.
Yes.
En las que me envió la vez pasada en PDF, están esas también.
No, se las voy a mandar más tarde.
Sí, porque yo estaba acordándome que no las había visto.
Y le voy a mandar también la del, creo que solo de la unidad 1 le mandé, creo.
Sí, solo la 1.
O sea, le voy a mandar la 2 y la 3. Se lo voy a mandar mañana.
Va, eso se la respondo y se la vuelvo a enviar, teacher.
Sí, para revisarlas. Ok, number 2, ¿cómo quedaría? We.
We are going to play.
Play.
Very good. Solo va a poner are going to play. Solo es completar la oración, no hacerla toda.
¿Ya la compraste aquí o allá?
Ok. Number 3. My sister.
Sister is to watch.
Is.
Watch.
Acuérdense que va antes
going to watch.
Going to watch. Okay, my sister is going to watch TV. Solo va a poner is going to watch. Okay. Number, what is the next one? Number 4. ¿Cómo quedaría la number 4? Espérame que se me fue esto. Okay, we have it here. ¿Cómo quedaría la number 4?
You are going to have.
You are going to have a picnic.
A picnic next Tuesday.
Very good. En esta de aquí, tiene que poner de nuevo el you, porque si solo pone are going to have, se la va a tomar como malo. Que aquí tienen que incluir you are going to have.
Justamente eso me pasó. Yo lo estaba haciendo directamente en la plataforma y no entendía por qué me decía que estaba mala.
Lo que pasa es que hay. Está ese de ahí. Entonces, por eso es que lo estamos haciendo juntos, por el hecho de que la plataforma a veces, no sé por qué, incluye el sujeto, pero en este específicamente tiene que incluir otra vez el you en ese espacio, you are going to have, y va a estar bueno. Ok, aquí nada más vamos a incluir lo que hace falta. Jane, ¿cómo quedaría?
Jane is going to
go. Going to go.
Going
to the office.
Go. Very good. Jane is going to go to the office. Solo lo que va a poner es esto. Ok. ¿Hay alguna pregunta? No. Ok. El día de mañana tenemos la sesión de one-on-one. Ok. Las personas que están scheduled para mañana solo son, son el caso de Carlos, Dora, que no está asistiendo, Daniel tampoco, y Julia. Básicamente, mañana voy a tener a dos personas. Entonces, Carlos iría de 10, nomás terminar la clase, 10 minutos sería la sesión, de 10 a 10 y 10. Si gusta, Carlos, podemos revisar las tareas de la unidad 3. Así como lo hicimos ahora, lo podemos hacer para que avancemos en ese aspecto.
Excelente, teacher.
Julia iría de 10 y 20, perdón, de 10 y 10 a 10 y 20. Entonces, Julia, también, si usted quiere, podemos revisar las tareas de la unidad 3 o las que le hace falta para que avancemos en ese aspecto. Y en este caso, como solo dos personas voy a tener, no sé si alguien se quiere, voluntario, se puede meter de 10 y 20 a 10 y 30, alguien más de 10 y 30 a 10 y 40 y alguien más de 10 y 40 a 10 y 50. Solo me avisan, piénsenlo y mañana me avisan si quieren meter para así hacer el, organizarnos bien el día de mañana.
Teacher.
Yes.
¿Y si me quiero meter yo en ese pleito?
No hay problema. Entonces quedaría usted de 10 y 20.
Hasta las 11, no hay problema.
No, por mí no, hay problema.
Joel.
Por mí no habría problema.
Gracias.
Porque igual yo estoy hasta las 11. O sea, tengo que estar una hora. Incluso si no se mete nadie, yo tengo que estar ahí en video. Si ustedes han revisado los videos de one on one, a veces solo he tenido dos o tres personas y los demás he puesto videos siempre enfocado a la clase o he hecho algún repaso de lo que se vio en la semana. Ok, Joel, entonces iría de 10 y 20 a 10 y media. No sé si alguien más se quisiera meter y me avisan mañana.
Teacher,
yes.
Antes de irme porque ya me dio hambre. En caso me salgo de la primera sesión con usted, con el mismo link, ¿puedo volver a entrar con la misma contraseña?
No, le voy a mandar mañana el link. Acuérdeme, si no lo mando antes de la clase, acuérdeme durante la clase para ponerlo en el grupo de WhatsApp.
No, o sea, me refiero yo para mis 10 minutos.
Sí, es otro link.
Es otro link para otros siguientes 10 minutos.
Sí, es que como terminamos la clase con un link, se ocupa otro link para la sesión de uno a uno.
Sí, sí, sí. Ajá, eso, por eso le pregunto. O sea, no es personalizado, a eso me quiero referir. No es personalizado el link, sino que las cuatro, por poner un ejemplo, las cuatro personas que vamos al one on one, usamos el mismo link y la diferente contraseña.
Sí, es el mismo link. Okay.
Ah, pues sí, ahí vamos a estar.
Okay. Very good. Okay, guys.
Thank you, teacher.
Welcome. Any question? Good night. Any question before finish? No questions?
Okay.
So see you tomorrow and have a nice night. Take care, guys. Good night.
Good night, teacher.